God has come to me again, saying, take a lamb, and with its blood, mark the lintel and posts of every door. For tonight, I shall pass through the land of Egypt and smite all the firstborn. But when I see the blood upon your door, I will pass over you, and the plague shall not enter.
You and your people have my permission to go.
Leave me!
Animal that is 1 year old male, you may take it from either the sheep or from the goats. You are to keep it until the 14th day of this month, and then the whole assembly of the community of Israel will slaughter the animals at twilight. They must take some of the blood and put it on the doorpost and the lintel of the houses where they eat them. They are to eat the meat on that night. They should eat it roasted over the fire along with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. Do not eat any of it raw or cooked in boiling water, but only roasted over the fire. Its head, as well as its legs and inner organs, you must not leave any of it until morning. Any part of it left until morning, you must burn.
These are your instructions for eating this meal. Be fully dressed, wear your sandals, and carry your walking stick in your hand. Eat the meal with urgency, for this is the Lord's Passover. On that night, I will pass through the land of Egypt and strike down every firstborn son and firstborn male animal in the land of Egypt. I will execute judgment against all of the gods of Egypt, for I am the Lord. But the blood of your doorpost will serve as a sign, making the houses where you are staying, where I see the blood, I will pass over you. This plague of death will not touch you when I strike the land of Egypt.
This day is to be a memorial to you, and you must celebrate it as a festival to the Lord. You are to celebrate it throughout your generations as a permanent statute.
Join me in our call to worship that can be found in this evening's bulletin. Jesus, thank you. Thank you for giving us a new command that we love one another.
Thank you
for showing us how to love by sitting at the table with your betrayer, Judas.
Thank you for forgiving us, loving us, and pouring yourself out so that we can be with you forever.
Forgive us for being like Judas at times in our own lives. Forgive us for trading your presence for the things of this world.
We praise you, Jesus, for showing us how to walk through the valley of the shadow of death by your power and grace. We praise you, Jesus, for preparing tables in the presence of our enemies.
Give us the grace, power, and strength each day to follow where you lead, serving others, especially our enemies, with love and humility like you did.
If you're able, let's stand and join in singing from the Take Me Sing, number 2254, or on the screen.
Thank you.
Are they servants of Christ? I'm talking like a madman. I'm a better one, with far more labors, many more imprisonments, far worse beatings, many times near death. 5 times. 5 times I received the 40 lashes minus one from the Jews. 3 times. 3 times I was beaten with rods. Once I received a stoning. 3 times I was shipwrecked. I have spent a night and a day in the open sea. On frequent journeys, I faced dangers from rivers, dangers from robbers, dangers from my own people, dangers from Gentiles, dangers in the city, dangers in the wilderness, dangers at sea, and dangers among false brothers. Toil and hardship, many sleepless nights, hunger and thirst, often without food, cold and without clothing. You may remain seated as we sing.
Passover celebration, Jesus knew that his hour had come to leave this world and return to his Father. He had loved his disciples during his ministry on earth, and now he loved them to every end. It was time for supper, and the devil had already prompted Jesus, son of Simon Iscariot, to betray Jesus. Jesus knew that the Father had given him authority over everything, and that he had come from God and would return to God. So he got up from the table, took off his robe, wrapped a towel around his waist, and poured water into a basin. Then he began to wash the disciples' feet, drying them with a towel he had around them. When Jesus came to Simon Peter, Peter said to him, "Look, are you going to wash my feet?"
Jesus answered him, "What I am doing, you don't realize now, but afterward, you will understand."
"No," Peter protested, "you will never, ever wash my feet."
Jesus said, "If I don't wash your feet, then you will have no part of me."
Simon Peter exclaimed, "Then wash my hands and head as well, Lord, not just my feet."
"One who is bathed doesn't need to wash anything except his feet, but he is completely clean. You are clean, but not all of you.
This is what he meant when he said, not all of you are clean. After washing their feet, he put on his robe again and sat down and asked, do you understand what I was doing? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, because that's what I am. And since I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash each other's feet. I have given you an example to follow. Do as I have done to you. I tell you the truth. Slaves are not greater than their master, nor is the messenger more important than the one who sends the message. Now that you know these things, God will bless you for doing them.
And then Jesus said, now the Son of Man is glorified, and God is glorified in him. If God is glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself, and I will glorify him at once. My children, I am with you a little longer. You will look for me. And just as I told the Jews, so now I tell you, where I am going, you cannot come. For I give you a new command, love one another, just as I have loved you. And you are also to love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you love one another. Join with me in the confession and the pardon as found in your bulletin. Let us declare our need for forgiveness and cleansing.
Jesus, our feet are dirty from the journey. We have not loved one another as you have loved us. Callousness and violence stain our hearts and lives. How will we become clean again? We see the table there, but who will make us clean and ready for the meal? Where will we find water for these soiled souls? Restore us to the joy of God's salvation. Amen.
On the night in which he was to give himself up for us, he took the bread and he gave thanks to you. He broke it. And he gave it to his disciples and said, take, eat, for this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Then when supper was over, he took the cup and he gave thanks to you. And he gave it to his disciples and he said, drink from this, all of you, for this is my blood. The blood of a new covenant poured out for you for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. And so in remembrance of these mighty acts in Jesus Christ, and we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and a living sacrifice in union with Christ offering for us. And in that we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen,
Christ will come again.
Almighty and gracious God, the God of Passover, the God of the Last Supper, the God of each and every day of all creation from the very the beginning, pour out your Holy Spirit onto everyone gathered into this room. Pour out your Holy Spirit onto those who are watching us online at this very moment and those who will be watching in days to come. Pour out your Holy Spirit onto these gifts of bread and fruit of the vine and make them to be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ and one with each other, one in ministry to all the world until Christ comes in the final victory and we feast at that banquet in heaven along with him. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with your Holy Spirit, your Holy Church. All honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. For those of you who are watching us online, for those of you who may be watching in the future, to be part of the rest of our experience of Holy Thursday, I challenge you to gather up some bread or crackers, something similar to bread that the Holy Spirit can bless. You have grape juice, wine, water. The Holy Spirit can turn water into wine more than once. Gather it. At the same time, I challenge you to gather a small bowl of water. A small bowl of water and maybe a paper towel or something to have that along with you. And I ask you one more thing, to gather up a piece of paper and a pen or a pencil, and you can be participating right along with everyone here. For those of you here, this evening we have brought you to take a journey from Passover to Passover, or Passover to the Last Supper. And in that, you have started at the door, that the God of grace and mercy, not the God of anger and vicious and hate, the God of grace and mercy, and mercy, who gave the Jews an opportunity to continue, placed blood on their door, and they were passed over. As we said and watched the video, I shared one of the hardest Bible stories to share with children. Probably pretty hard for most of us adults. But then you walked and you walked the journey, and we listened to Paul writing about everything that he could look back on and see, and he was writing about all the things that he had done. Now, there are those of us in theology classes would say Paul was a big braggart. But Paul was simply expressing the frustration that many of us in this walk. Why them? Why me? Why not me? Why not them? Paul was saying, look at all the things I've done for the Lord. Over there on that paper for tonight, I'm going to challenge you to take a piece of paper or two. And I want you to write on it what, as if you were Paul sitting there and writing, what would you tell the Lord you have done for the gospel? And take it with you. Don't want you to leave it. Take it with you. And then as you travel, and for those of you at home, that's where you would use your paper there. As here, there is a bowl on the organ, and it has red, water-washable finger paint. Go back to kindergarten. There are wet wipes and there are paper towels. Always an option. But I call you to imagine, had there been no Passover, there'd be no Passover. Place your mark upon your door. For those of you at home, I'm not asking you to place paint on your door. Take some of that water. Go out and put a blessing on your door. And then our last station is where the water in the basin is. As you travel to that, I ask you to, if you wish, there's a towel there, some paper towels, just touch your hand there. If you wish to push, put it on your feet, put it on your head, just to touch it. And remember that we serve a servant Messiah. See, we all think this is about the bread and the juice tonight, but tonight it's about the foot washing. Our culture doesn't take kindly to that, but I want you to have that as you make your journey for tonight. And again, you don't have to do it in any order, as it could get crowded at one or the other, but visit all, and your last stop, and you at home, come to kneel at the altar, unless you choose to pick up a cup in the back, with a pre-made Holy Communion you made, but you come, and we will offer you the unleavened bread and the juice at the altar rail in your Holy Communion. When you finish all, then you may return, and we will continue with the worship when everyone is finished. We call you to begin your journey from Passover to Passover.
you, Jay? The body of Jesus given for you. Share the body of Jesus given for you because he loves you.
Thank you.
have journeyed from Passover to Passover, from the call to perform and be part of the gospel, to be the servant, to be served, and then to take the bread and the cup. There's a lot of thoughts in many denominations about the bread and the cup. But one that came to mind in this week as I was preparing for all the services. James did such a good job, and I'm going to uncover it for him. This was not shared with 11. This was shared with 12. Judas took from the cup. Judas was not excluded, for Jesus excludes no one. No, you are part of that creation. You are part of Passover, to servants, to writing, to sharing in that. Know that in the name of Jesus, you are forgiven. Amen. Let us join in singing number 292, verses 1, 2, and 3. As you're able, I'll ask you to stand.
Ear to Peter. Savior and act it out after it's too late. As we go from tonight to tomorrow night, even darker, and then Saturday, when there's nothing on Saturday, they all left. The disciples were packed up.
Him. side, my Lord.
There you are.